all this water in the streets and also seeping into homes, the basements, the first floors, and so many of you, as we said, have been asking us, is it contaminated? And ABC's chief medical editor, Dr. Richard Besser, went out to get a sample to test it, and he's here now with the results. So what happened, Rich?
Well, you know, I wanted to show you why you have to be so incredibly careful, whether the water's in your house or it's on the street. So I headed down to Lower Manhattan, where there's still a lot of area that's underwater, and I collected a sample. You know, I wore gloves and I wore boots to make sure that none of this water would come in contact with my skin, because it can be very, very damaging. I took it to the Ambient Group Lab, which is a laboratory which specializes in water testing. Now, the water looked totally clear, but it just about knocked me over from the smell. It was loaded with petroleum, with gasoline, very strong, and that can be very dangerous if you come in contact with it. We then put it through testing. Now, if it has bacteria, sewage in it, it glows purple just like that. And our water's being tested, and we'll have that result tomorrow. But, you know, this is water that is very dangerous. It's contaminated with bacteria and with all kinds of chemicals.
And you have been saying to me all day long, if it gets on anything in your house, first of all, wear gloves, but even a closed package, a can,
do not use it. This is the question people have. Any food, any canned goods, anything that came in contact with flood water, it's best to just get rid of it. Any other things, pots, plates, those kinds of things, have to be scrubbed with water, soaked in bleach before you use those. This can be very dangerous, and you can prevent illness if you follow these strict rules.
Soak them in bleach first, you're saying.
That's right. Dilute bleach in water.
Okay. It can make you sick, and you'll be back with your final results tomorrow on what you found in that water. Thank you, Rich.